I've gone through my CD collection and tried to group the ones that were around the same time frame of when I acquired them. So, their music videos were everywhere. I think they were both on Disney Channel, and they were both, like, not only there, but they were also, I think, Nickelodeon's kind of music video things, like the Slime Time Live stuff. And, yeah, they were also one of the first CDs that I ever had. And, I think when I got the CD, I actually had it with, like, a special version that had, like, a little calendar thing, and I don't have it anymore. Like, I don't know what happened to that. I don't know what I did to that. I think I had it, but I don't know. And... yeah, there's just so much to say about this one. Like, oh my gosh, just look at this green. Like, look at it. Look at that green. I don't know what it is. It's just, there's something about that intense green. I just was always, like, in love with that. Like, and then you got this cool, like, all of the photos that were for this thing. I'm just gonna show the photo public, because... it was just, all of the photos were, like, mind-blowingly really, really cool to me. I used to just look at these photos. I really should be, like, talking about it while I'm doing this, though, okay, so I don't get confused. So... there's a lot to say about A-Teens. I didn't know when I was listening to them that they were Swedish, and I did not know when I would listen to them that they actually started off as an ABBA cover group until later when I was in Europe, like a few years later, and I actually purchased their first, I think it was actually their first one, the ABBA Generation CD, which was just them doing covers of ABBA songs, and it was so great. Like, that was, that was partially my introduction to ABBA music. How fitting that I would mention that when the, like, what's going on right now, and they're apparently ABBA is making a comeback. Okay, so anyway, I used to watch Bouncing Off the Ceiling Upside Down and try to replicate the dances from it, and me and my sister would kind of practice that, and I loved all the outfits. I loved the dancing. Their makeup was, like, so cool. They always had, like, a little bit of just the right amount of, like, glitteriness, you know? And I think they were all wearing makeup. I think the guys were too. But anyway, so... yeah, you had so many artists at the time doing all these songs that would be, like, so very adult. And then you had some who actually were teenagers who had songs that were, like, teenager kind of songs. And that's actually something I really liked about A-Teens. So, I mean, like, as I grew up, like, as I entered my teens, like, I didn't feel like this was, like, too mature for them or anything like that. Like, I actually was like, yeah, I agree with this. Yeah, I agree with that. It was like, they really did capture, teenhood, you know? In a fun way, and just a vibrant way that was like, I don't think I had ever heard any music that was that genre before. It wasn't just, like, pop, but it was, like, they had a special form of pop that was kind of like the way that, like how ATC was. So it was kind of like an introduction to that kind of, like, electronic pop. And, it was just something special about them. So, Bouncing Off the Ceiling, I used to watch that one a million times. Also fell in love with the Punch Buggy, like, as a kid at some point, and I, like, really loved that they had, like, they had Punch Buggies in the video. I was like, ah! Anyway, to the music, you could just, like, imagine the party with some of these songs. Like, to the music, you could just imagine the parties being thrown. Their music videos were incredible too. Halfway Around the World had a perfect video. It went perfectly with what you were hearing. Like, it's exactly what I would have imagined that video to be for that song. Firefly should have had a music video. I wish it had. I just thought it was a really cool song. It was one of my favorites off of this CD. I would listen to it again and again and again. It's just, I always kind of pictured her becoming like a fairy or a firefly or something. Like, just kind of like this, kind of like the color scheme of the M2M Mirror music video. You know how it's got like blues and greens and blacks and stuff like that? I pictured like that kind of color setting, but like for Firefly. The Sugar Rush is still one of my favorite songs of all time. Dream Street did a cover of it, and I found out about Dream Street like a little bit later, and I'll go into that too. I preferred their version of Sugar Rush. It's, you know, the original. I don't know why. I had a friend who liked the Dream Street version more. That's okay, but I still like the version. Rockin', I always picture them, like, literally in a kind of fancy spaceship, and they're, like, aliens, and they are in contact with some news reporter on Earth who's trying to report about them. Like, that's what I picture with the song Rockin'. Something about what they're doing with their voices in that song, and the way that it is set up both musically, and just something about the lyrics made me always think that in my mind. Around the Corner of Your Eye always made me sad. I mean, some people could take it as a stalker song, but I didn't. I just saw it as more of like she's just waiting for him to see her. It just always really, really depressed me. Slammin' Kinda Love actually was a little bit didn't like as much as the other songs ever. I mean, I like it, but All My Love also was kind of like Slammin' Kinda Love, and I didn't like it as much as the other songs. For All That I Am was a really sweet one. That's What It's All About. Made me think of them kind of partying again. Morning Light also made me think of that, but also Morning Light, I also kind of used to wonder about it, like, are they saying that they're aliens? I was obsessed with that whole, like, mysterious thing. Another party song. It was kind of like a funny party song because it's like, it's like they're trying to say, we know you don't want us to party, but we're going to anyway. And then there's the hidden track, and after I first heard the hidden track, I then kind of grew obsessed with trying to find out if any of my other CDs had hidden tracks. And I don't know the name of it, but it's the one where she sing about, I think it's called Don't Even Know Your Name, but she's like talking about seeing somebody every day on the bus, and it actually sounds more adult than the rest of the songs, like kind of a sad story where she's like pining away for a stranger. But it's a really beautiful song, and I don't know why they put that like so hidden, where it's like you won't notice it unless you listen and you just like let it keep playing and playing and playing, and then finally the silence ends and that song comes on. Anyway, I have other iTunes CDs, I'll review them too. Still though, one of my favorites of all time.